Heroes will be made and dreams will come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Nick and I will find out starting in today's game between the Oklahoma Sooners and the LSU Tigers.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Tigers know they're in for a fight tonight, Dick. What are their keys to succeed this evening?
Hey, if you ask me, the keys are simple, Brad. First of all, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Second, try not to give up any good looks from the outside. Lastly, make sure every possession you have is a good possession. Don't turn the rock over.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action and see what's in store for us. Both teams looking to get things going here. Number 30, pump fakes. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Can't get the shot to go. Looking for a good shot. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
Perfectly executed.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad. Shot didn't fall in, but it was a great use of the screen.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. Here's a spin down to the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. He used the sky hook, the jump hook, and now the spin move to the goal. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beat.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Post flashes. He shoots from the top of the circle. That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
On the dribble, gives it up. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
High post screen.
Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline.
Up and inside.
Number one with the ball. They still don't score. Dickie's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Number 21 takes the feed. Good fake. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Nice move with a face up.
I tell you one thing, Brad, I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
He goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
Had an open guy in the post and went the other way. Launches away. Off the rim and no good. Moving it around the perimeter. Number 23 takes the pass. Number 23 is feeling great right now.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
Jump hook from the low block. They're really losing confidence with their poor shooting at the time, Dick.
Hey, nothing that a couple of fast break dunks could cure.
Another turnover.
We're not talking apple turnovers either.
What should they do here, Dick?
Let's call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you got to think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
Number 20 picks up the foul. First personal foul. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick down here on the sidelines. It looks like the losing team is starting to get a little bit anxious. Their coaches are reminding them just to relax. My observation is it looks like these bright lights have gotten the best of this team so far in the first half.
Nice fake.
Goes for the steal down low, and he didn't get it.
I tell you, he took a chance, and he lost, baby.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, the battle in the paint has played a major factor in this game and is probably some of the reason why they have this lead. If things don't change in a hurry, this game could get ugly, guys.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
I'll tell you one thing, you better be able to establish post play because that gives you inside-outside action.
Trying to feed the low block. Turns it over. He puts up the tray.
Nice job of using the screen to get open for that good shot.
Reverses the ball after having a guy in the post. Looking for contact. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Had a momentary look from three-point land. He unloads. He gets another shot off and in.
Hey, this show's about to start, Brad.
They go into the low block.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have gotten to him about a second earlier.
Jumps into the defender. He drains the bucket.
Wow, can we get slow-mo, please?
Inside, trying to draw some contact.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
Tries for two, way off target. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. The center gets the pass. And he missed. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. He attempts a jump hook. Can't get the shot to go. On the outside. Gave it up. Trying to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby.
On the inside. There they come with a double team to stop it. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Now trying to feed the low block. They work it back to the outside. They'll work it around the arc. He's got a nice shot fake. For the bucket, and off the mark. This young guy is a crowd favorite, Dick.
The fans know exactly how much he has done for this program.
Mm-hmm. The center gets the ball. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
They work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Basket falls despite the contact. On the dribble, gives it up. Three. Off the rim and no good. Well, that's good defense. A steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
The Tigers have a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch.
For two, and in and out. And he'll kick it back outside. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball or let him try to beat us.
He puts up the three ball. Off the mark. To the circle.
Wow, what a super job of running his man into the screen for that sweet jumper.
Number three is trying to get the crowd involved now.
Hey, Brad, he's looking for some additional encouragement for this offensive possession.
The replay will give us a better look.
The ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Number 21 comes up with it. Off the mark. At the end of the first half, the Sooners are ahead by five. LSU collected very few rebounds out there, Mr. Vitale. Is it a lack of aggression, you think?
Hey, if they're lacking aggression, that would mean they had some to begin with. I saw no aggressiveness towards rebounding in the first half.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Nice defensive rebound. They clear it ahead in transition.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
He shoots from the top of the circle.
Oh, you gotta knock those down. Great screen, but no go.
That spin move's not gonna work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Coming inside.
Questionable call there, Dick.
That's one of those calls that can go either way.
Number 14 steps to the line for the first time. He makes the first shot. He sinks it. Dumps it in. He attempts a jump hook. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. He looks for three. Way off target. Picked out of the air. Looking for a good shot. He goes for three. Off the rim and no good. Has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Check that out. He's pumping up the crowd. He wants him to turn it up a notch.
He's saying, show me some love. I'm working my tail off here.
He's got the post flashing if he wants it. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Stolen. They get out on the break. With a bucket. The lay-in. He goes for three. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's doing it all right now for this team. It'll be interesting to see if he can keep this up.
Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Ball goes out of bounds. Boy, it's so important when you're getting points off turnovers. And look at that stat.
I'll tell you one thing. Coaches go nuts. If that stat's negative, it absolutely makes you lose the air and you get balled like I am.
There's a double team waiting there. Robs him of the ball. There's the pick. With a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. And that guy had 1,400 on his boards. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
Stolen ball. On the outside. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see raw man. That's essential when you play on there and you're fronting.
They work the perimeter. Let's it fly. Way off target. The point guard receives the pass. Picked off. On the dribble, gives it up. And a momentary look from three-point land. Looking for a screen on top and got it.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set.
It's even more important they don't have talented guards like they have.
Yeah. Whistle blown, basket's good, and one.
That's concentration, baby.
He goes to the line for the first time. Good. Ouch. Screener took the worst of that one. Dickey's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
For the bucket. Rims out. The shooting guard handles the pass. Off the rim and no good. For two, they still don't score. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Gave it up. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, this is what people wanted to see, a close championship game. The action and intensity has really picked up down here, guys. Everyone wants to see a great finish.
Got a nice screen. Doesn't go. They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
Intercepted. The point guard receives the ball. Goes up for two. LSU have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He intercepts it. Working it around the perimeter. Picks off the lazy pass.
Look at that spacing.
On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from the top of the key. Sinks the shot.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
For two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
The center handles the feed. There's the pick. There's the roll.
Look at this last play right here. A 5-point lead could go either way with this much time, Brad.
Oh, it certainly can, Dick.
Up and inside.
For the deuce. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is. Pressure on the ball. Hit on the ball.
He tries the three. Rims out. The Tigers call a timeout. And let's go courtside. Erin Andrews.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
All right, thanks, Erin. I get a feeling they changed things up a little bit, Dick.
We'll see what they come up with, Brad.
I knew this was going to be a dandy, baby.
The lead is down to three. He strips him clean. Tries for two. Was that beautiful or what? defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off.
Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Off the rim and no good. Nice steal there, but the offense gets the ball back. It's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. How's the front court productivity tonight, Dick?
You know, Brad, basketball is a big man's game. If you have a few on your team and are active and energetic, it makes your team that much better. Ultimately, you want all of your players to be productive, but an inside presence will separate your team from others.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And yet another foul.
Good teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
Second shot, good. Coach calls for a timeout. He wants to talk some things over. See if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Nice shot. Shot clock is dead. Wow, man, that stops the clock again. Goes to the free throw line. Lots of rim, but not in.
They really need a score here to turn this into a one possession game.
Rims out. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Turnovers, Dick. They just kill you every time.
I'll tell you, Brad, they sure do. You must keep the number to a minimum in order to maximize your number of shot attempts.
Makes the front end of the 1-1. Good, but the result. They're not getting it done from the free throw line tonight, Dick.
It always seems like these close games, Brad, come down to free throw shooting. Let's see how this poor display affects them.
And yet another foul. With the freebie. First shot is good. Hits the second shot. Timeout's called.
Time is not on their side right now, Brad. They need some big shots, baby. Sometimes timeouts can take teams right out of their rhythm, Brad. Let's see what happens here.
It's a four-point game.
This one could go either way. Don't give up your seat. They have to foul to send them to the line and hope they miss.
Oh, and look at the crowd and look at the reaction.
I tell the home fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
A chance for two. No doubt. Thank you. the charity strike. Ready to start again. He shoots from outside, drains the shot. Resume the action. And they'll decide this one in overtime.
That's how games like this ought to be, baby. Play the extra period. Regulation couldn't solve anything. These teams are headed into overtime.
NCAA tournament, and we are in overtime. Two evenly matched teams. They played well throughout. Extra session coming up, Richard. You can't ask for more than this.
I tell you, Brad, I know you and I love it. The players love it. The coaches love it. But isn't it going to be sad that one of these clubs are going to walk out of here with an L?
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Drains it. Tigers will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here. On the outside. He does the sweet fake shot. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He's taken too many unnecessary shots, Dick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
Let's watch the move as he works his man and on a fadeaway jumper.
STOP, this place will be off the charts if they can get a stop here, Brad.
He attempts the trifecta. He nails the bucket. And he'll kick it back outside. He unloads a three. Off the rim and no good. He lets it fly. Perfectly designed, perfectly executed, easy basket. He shoots from right of the circle. He makes the shot. It looks as though the students are all wound up and ready to agitate the opposition.
They're rocking right now, my goodness.
Pass down low, there's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step, very slow.
He grabs the board. The outside for the bucket. They still don't score. Up, easy one. Well, the defender goes down, but there's no call either way.
Wow, no call right there. I think that was a good call though by the official.
Gave it up. Nice shot fake. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Goes up for two. Easy one. back to the action now in a half court. Let's see what they set up, Dick. Dick, what do you do with a 7-point lead?
Hey, they keep playing and continue to do what's gotten them this far, Brad. Can't change now.
Launches away. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby. Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively.
That's a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
He tries the three ball. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
That I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, try to deny, but then he does a great job of post position, spreading his body and getting the ball.
Timeout's been called. Let's check in with Aaron.
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. What kind of energy are we looking at after that timeout, Dick?
That's winning energy, baby. The team with the most energy and execution goes home with the big W.
For two.
Don't waste a lot of time. Foul right away.
There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important.
Gets the second shot. Way out on top, controlling the ball. Rims out. Looking to move it around the perimeter.
Dump it inside.
Almost lost the basketball. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that. And it's heartbreak for the other club. But, you know, you've got to win it. Keep on going. And get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. And that was the difference in the game.
Oklahoma opened the tournament with an impressive first-round victory.
Winning that game was so important. A big first win not only keeps the team's championship hopes alive, but does wonders to calm these kids' nerves entering the second round.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.